Hello friends, welcome to Apple Friendly. Apple's guided access feature locks user screen on one specific app and prevents users from switching to another app or returning to home screen. This can be used as a parental control feature. So without further ado, let's get started. So first up, launch your settings app, scroll down, tap general, then tap accessibility, then scroll down again and tap guided access under learning section. Here put this toggle on to switch on the guided access feature. And now you have some more related settings appearing here. So let us look at them one by one. So first one is passcode settings. So let's tap on it. Now here you have two options. Now you can use your touch ID to end your guided access sessions. So put this toggle on to use that feature. And the next option is set guided access passcode. Here you can set up a 6-digit passcode to start or end your guided access sessions. So for a demo purpose, I'll set my passcode as 6x0. And again, I'll reconfirm my passcode. That's it. We are done here. So let us go back and check other settings. Now the next setting is time limits. Let us tap on it. Now here you have two options. First one is sounds. Let's tap on it. So here you can select an alarm sound which will notify you once your guided access is over. So you can select an alarm sound from this preloaded list, or you can make your own alarm sound or your own ringtone. And to do that, see the link in the description. But for a demo purpose, I'll select any random alarm sound from this preloaded list and I'll go back. Now the next option is speak. If I put this toggle on, it will speak the time before my guided access ends. So based on your preference, you keep it on or off. I'll just put it off and I'll go back. Now let us move on to the last setting, that is accessibility shortcut. Accessibility is a feature where you tap your home button 3 times and a pop-up menu appears. Let me show you how it works. So I'll put the toggle on and I'll tap my home button 3 times. So here is the menu. As you can see here, guided access is available now. So from now, whenever I want to use guided access feature on any app, I can triple tap my home button and I can select guided access from this menu. So let me cancel it for now. We have completed setting up all these settings. Now let us go to home screen and open an app. Let me open calculator. Let us apply guided access to this app and lock our screen to this particular app and disable all hardware buttons. So to do that, first triple click your home button. Now tap guided access. Now before starting the guided access, we need to adjust some more settings. So let us look at them one by one. First up, let us tap on options. So now here you have different options like sleep wake button, volume buttons, motion, keyboards, touch, time limit. If you keep these options off, the respective functions would be disabled, like your sleep wake button and your volume buttons won't work for this particular session. And putting the motion toggle off would prevent the screen orientation from portrait to landscape or landscape to portrait. Putting the keyboard toggle off prevents the system keyboard to open up for this particular session and in this particular app. Similarly, putting the touch toggle off completely disables the user touch input on the screen. And the last option is time limit. Here you can set up a time for this particular session on this particular app. And once the time limit is complete, user won't be able to use that app anymore. So for a demo purpose, I'll set it up to 1 minute. Now let us look at the another option. And this is really cool. Now here what you can do is, you can draw on your screen and you can disable that particular part of the screen. You can draw circles, you can draw rectangles, you can draw any shape that you want to draw. And you can add as many areas as you want. Let me draw a rectangle and disable the bottom part of the screen so that I won't be able to use numbers 1, 2, 3, 0, plus sign or equal sign. I can adjust this area using these handles, or I can delete it using that small X button on the top left corner. That's it. I'll tap start and my gadget access is on. Now my session is on, and as you can see, if I type 7, 8, 9, 4, 5, 6, and if I go to 1, 2, 3, or 0, or plus sign or equal sign, I'm not able to use it because that part of the screen, that gray part, is disabled for the touch input. And if I wait for some more time, as you can see, my session is over. And now user cannot use the screen, user cannot use any of the hardware button, or you cannot do anything with your phone. Now you can use your touch ID to end the session, or you can triple tap home button to bring up the passcode option. Now here you have to input your 6-digit passcode that we had set up in settings. Now again, it will give you two more options. Either you can end the session or you can resume the session. I'll just end it up. And one more thing, if you want to change your passcode again, go back to settings again, tap passcode settings and input your new passcode. Now this passcode would be used for your next guided access sessions. So that's it for this video, guys. Hope it helps you. Give it a thumbs up if you like the video. Thank you for watching. Subscribe and stay tuned for my next videos. Thank you.